Temperament frets is you compensated what's wrong with the guitar. So now, finally, you have your dark tranquility shirt, so maybe you're not playing like bar chords or even any thirds and so on. But still, if you want to do this, it's cool. You can sit here if you like in front of it's totally cool if you don't mind. So there is no other guitar, unfortunately, around here. Well, it's a fine store and everything. Of course, you should sell your guitars, but then you should send the neck to Sweden and have it refretted. Because this one has perfect intonation on every fret. And when was the last time you played an E chord? Did it sound like this? Never. Anyway, so I'm gonna play, and then I'm gonna again show my penis and stage dive for no reason at all. And when I play music, I improvise, and sometimes when you improvise, it's turning into, again, scheisse. And it's okay, because I could never travel around the world and sing about dragons and fire and steam. I just couldn't do it and play exactly the same solos that's on the albums and everything. And after solo, everything would turn blue and the big dragon would come up from behind of the fan and my big ugly Swedish Viking hair would... I would rather kill myself. So I do improvise and take chances. And sometimes you suck, and it's okay. It's a part of life, you know. Don't be afraid. It will. Most of the stuff with me on YouTube, there are 4 million clips. It's like, oh God, you know, I never watch it because I realized it's from the worst possible angle, of course, and only 500,000 people watch it. The sound is terrible, and I play like crap because I'm jet lagged or whatever. And again, it's a part of life. Sometimes you can't find your left shoe, and sometimes you whatever, you know. And sometimes you're really good, and that's worth to take the chance. So I improvise. When I write music, I always try to find my own moustache instead of having somebody else's moustache. You know, you're like, hey, I like Yngwie Malmsteen. Whatever. Or I'm into Steve Vai. And so on. It's like, yeah, it's already been done. You know, why would you spend a year practicing? All right. Yeah. Hey, just move it one fret up. Sure, it sounds like shit, but it's your moustache. You just gotta figure out who you are and why you are that way and how to get that through in your playing. So I wrote this song. The first one is called In the Goo of the Evening, and it's in B minor for the very dedicated people here. Oh, it's in B minor, great. I'm a low end that you can play something and it doesn't shit itself in the pan. So many amps when you turn it all the way up to 11 and you start to so on, it just collapses, you know. But this one doesn't. It's completely stable. And this is just a 2x12 cab. So if you buy 14 of this with 4 in them, it's going to be really funny hair after you play like a gig. So anyway, I improvised and I wrote this. Has a melody goes. As you would say, because you speak French, I couldn't find the moustache of the song, so I need to make it smell Swedish. So what I did is I took the first note and played it as harmonic by hitting the string, and then I played the rest of the melody on the high E string without choking the melody. Started to sound after Fred or whatever, you know, Swedish guy. You have to figure out what your moustache is, you know. Maybe you have to pee-pee in the pickup or whatever, it doesn't matter. But to have a moustache is to frame your life with something more funny. Yeah, you have a beautiful moustache. Very good. You have a beautiful pee, yes. Anyway, so I'll just play this, and this is the only thing I know I'm going to play. The rest may be catastrophic.
Catastrophic. We shall see. Oh, it's going to be loud. Here we go.
Yeah. turn down the backing track a little bit, that was good. I can't actually hear anything. So tapping is very much freedom for me. I can play pretty much anything I hear in my head. Just by, you know, going back and forth and looking at the guitar almost like a piano, okay? With, you can play really big intervals. So. I'm gonna do a song that you can't dance to. It's a tapping, chromatic tapping song, and it's from an album called Freak It On The Road Less Travel, and it's chromatic scale, you know. The world's greatest chromatic melody. So what I do here is basically I tap. Just let the hand roll down. And then I stole some chords from Stevie Wonder. He didn't mind, he said. And then the actual backing track is like Slayer on acid. Well, probably on acid all the time, I don't know. And then the lead part is, I use something called a symmetric scale. Can you give me 2 seconds? I play in a very funny way, so I fuck up the pickups.
2 seconds, I will just find a screwdriver, because I want you to have a maximum hi-fi experience. So I pickup a little bit. Yes, yeah. Yes? So I don't know what I do, but I do everything wrong and backwards. So, and this is like a hey, guitar shop kind of. You have the screwdriver in a matching cover, then you take the screwdriver and you do this. And don't hurt yourself, you know. So, yes. Do you want the screwdriver? I'll sign the screwdriver afterwards. I'm such a cool guy. So, and since it's Saturday, so I doubled throughout the drink screwdriver. Anyway, I do a little bit of tapping, and again, the symmetric scale, like the Eurovision Song Contest and stuff like that. That would be really a good health, mental health kind of improvement, you know. Next year, every song from every country has to be written with the symmetric scale. Have you heard of Panzerballett? I love Panzerballett. It's probably the best thing ever happened to Germany. Check out your local band. Panzerballett. It's good stuff.
My German is a bit rusty. I read German in school, but I forgot everything. But one sentence is really important. I can say Fleisch und Ecke. And I can say Blutjägerstein and Weissbier, but it's not really the same thing. So the only reason I started to read German was because of Accept and Nina Hagen, believe it or not. So yeah, that was really weird. The French, well, you're not really French, but anyway, they didn't really have anything as cool as Accept or Nina Hagen. So, well, maybe you hate Nina Hagen, I don't give a shit. Here's a song called There's No Money in Jazz, and don't try to dance to this one. Circus Music, Slayer, Stevie Wonder, and a bit of Miles Davis. And that together is Mattias Eklundh, band Johannes Eklundh.